Hi. This instructional video is about transformations. Transformations, particularly, is about rigid transformations. And as you recall, the rigid transformations is made up of three basic movements. One is a rotation, the other is a reflection over a given axis or line of reflection, and the third is a translation, which will lead into a discussion of vectors. Translation, the horizontal and the vertical movement along the coordinate plane. And this one is asking to plot these three points, and we're supposed to determine the distance between the points A and B. And then we're supposed to transform it by reflecting it over the line of reflection where x is equal to 2, and then rotate it. Holy moly, it's a lot of stuff going on. And also, if you remember from the past, the distance formula between any two given points, you may recall, is the square root of the difference of the two x's, x2 minus x1, squared, and you add that to the difference of the two y-coordinates, y2 minus y1, squared. So we're going to use this formula to determine the points between A and B, and then, after the two transformations, to prove the congruency between the two, or the isometry between the two polygons, we're going to do another distance formula between the new A and B points, so that if they're congruent, that will numerically prove that they retain the size and the shape of the polygon. So, to get this started, we're going to have to first draw the coordinate plane and plot these points. Let's do that. All right, there we have it. Now, what we're going to do, according to the direction, we're going to determine the distance between the points A and B, and then reflect it over the polygon, over the line, where the line goes through the x-axis at the 2. Okay, let's do that first. So, along the x-axis, it's going to go through the 2, so it's going to be a vertical line. And this is the line in which the polygon, the triangle, is going to reflect. Just like a line of symmetry when we study the concept of quadratic functions, where the left side of the parabola is congruent to that of the right side. Okay, so first, the distance formula is d is equal to square root of the x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1, the whole difference squared. So let's go and label, recognize the A as x1, y1, and let's call this B the x2, y2, the second coordinate pair. So x2 is going to be negative 8, minus x1 is going to be negative 1, we're going to square that, plus y2 is going to be 10, minus y1 is going to be 2, and square that, and whatever that's going to be, we're going to square root that as well. The negative 8 plus 1 is going to be negative 7, and of course, 10 minus 2 is 8. We're going to square that. We're showing it step by step here. And in turn, that becomes 49 plus 64. And thus, that's become square root of 113. And since 113 is a prime number, and we'll leave our answer as a radical. So the distance between A and B is going to be square root of 113. And of course, if you're curious to see what the real number of the value square root of 113 is, it shows here 10.63 units, all right? So which is about 10.63 units away. All right, very good. And now we're going to reflect it over the line of reflection where x is equal to 2. Now, just like a line of symmetry of a quadratic function, we're going to have to count the number of units away from the line of reflection to that coordinate, the x value, that is. So from here, we got 1, 2, 3. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, that away. And what's the new coordinate for this guy? It's going to be from the origin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. The y value does not change. So this is 5 and 2. And that's the new a. But we won't label that as a yet, okay? And then the b from the line of reflection, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 units away. 10 units. It's 8 units away from the y-axis, but it is 10 units away from the line of reflection. So we're gonna count towards the right this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And in turn, that becomes 10, well, let me see. Let's see, hold on. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Whoa, careful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There it is. And that 10 units away from the line of reflection is in fact 12 units away from the y-axis. So the x value is 12 and the y value does not change. It did not go up or down. We just went along the horizontal line. And then the c was a 0, 6. And that was 1, 2 units away from the line of reflection. So we're gonna go 1, 2 units away to the right. And that becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6, which does not change. And now I'm going to draw a line between each of those vertices, the new vertices. And here is our new triangle. Same shape. Same angle, so therefore they are congruent. It's just, it's on a different quadrant now. So that's a reflection.